The Honourable Member from Summerside-Wilmot.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. This week is Transgender Awareness Week, a time to listen, celebrate the victories of trans people, and remember those who have lost their lives to anti-trans violence. It's an important time for each of us to reaffirm our commitment to the ongoing work of being allies. And that is ongoing work, because we're always learning, and we'll make mistakes, but that's part of it. Of all the things I could highlight, I think the most important is to really listen. Listen to what the trans people in your community are saying, and commit to acting on what you learn. If you've only ever considered the world from a cisgendered perspective, it will no doubt be eye-opening how many things may affect trans people that didn't previously feel problematic to you because they've never affected you. But such as things like language people use in a given space or having access to gender-neutral bathrooms. But just because something isn't a problem for you doesn't mean it isn't a problem. And creating an environment that feels comfortable for trans people to vocalize their issues is critical. I encourage everyone to take the time to learn and better recognize systemic barriers that trans and gender diverse people continue to face, particularly in this house when we talk about policies, programs, and initiatives. A good example of that is requiring a doctor to validate your gender identity. I thank the Justice Minister for agreeing with me that this is unnecessary, and I'll look forward to him updating the House that this has been changed. We also need to hear the concerns that are being raised in this community about the gender-affirming care clinic only operating 2 days a month. That makes it really hard to get into, and it doesn't even seem to be listed on government's website anywhere. There's a lot of work to be done, and we all need to be aware of it. Let Trans Awareness Week remind all of us that this week and every week, we need to listen to and learn from trans voices. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.